Love first on the show. The Indian Medical Association has questioned the scientific basis of the government's recently released protocol based on Ayurveda and yoga for the prevention as well as treatment of asymptomatic and mild patients of COVID-19. Union Health Minister Harsh Vardhan released a protocol for the clinical management of COVID-19 that lists dietary measures, yoga, Ayurveda herbs, as well as a formulation such as ashwagandha and Ayush 64 for prevention of coronavirus infection and treatment of mild and asymptomatic cases. Now, the health body, the IMA, has said, is there satisfactory evidence regarding the claims made from studies done on COVID patients based on the above criteria? Well, to talk more about this very, very strongly worded letter that the IMA has written, we're now joined by Dr. Rajan Sharma, president of the Indian Medical Association. Dr. Sharma, very, very strong letter in which you've actually asked the health minister to provide proof of these claims that are being made.
Yeah,
So if you can tell us a bit more about the letter and these questions, there's a list of questions that you've stated in the letter. If you can tell us about that.
See, we have the following posers for the Union Health Minister, who happens to be a practitioner of modern medicine.
That's right.
Before beginning his political life. If you have a satisfactory evidence regarding the claims made from the studies done on COVID-19, patients based on the above criteria for weak or moderate cases or asymptomatic should be, this information should be in public domain and available for scientific scrutiny. And what is holding back? That if it is such a good thing, why is it holding back this data? Has to clarify whether the severe form of COVID-19 is a hyperimmune status or immune deficiency status. The entire country, ever since this began, is on an immunity booster trip. Everybody is taking whether modern scientific medicines or Ayurveda medicines. But I would also like him to come clean that whether they are proponents of this claim and his ministry is prepared to subject themselves as volunteer to an independent double controlled trial study. As you are aware, the entire country is aware, charity always begins at home. He should publicly give a statement that he will only follow COVID protocols by Ayush Ministry. And if Ayush Ministry's protocols are so good, then does it imply handling over the COVID protocol, COVID-19 management to Ayush Ministry? So many of the ministers in the current government, politicians across the state, leaders, party leaders have been affected with COVID, and allopathic medicine, modern medicine, has risen up to that bar to get them out of that. And you cannot have double standards, one set of rules for the ruling elite and other set of rules for the public. When I speak today, I speak on behalf of the Indian public. As a doctor, I have to make my presence felt so that people stay at home having all these things might not neglect their symptoms and succumb to this disease.
Right, absolutely. In fact, the Ayush minister himself had to undergo a long treatment in hospital. But a very interesting line, doctor, in your letter was about how this is inflicting, what's being recommended has not been proven and no experiments done, then it's inflicting a fraud on the nation and that gullible patients by calling placebos as drugs. And this point that you're making about gullible patients, about, you know, Indians at large, all these immunity boosters that many feel that are protecting them but aren't really protecting them in the face of this pandemic. And it's important to get that message out there.
I don't have anything against Ayurveda.
Sure.
Fine. Go ahead. But don't befool my public. You cannot have double standards in life. Giving such advice, actually, in my views, I'm sorry to use these words, is actually criminal.
Right, and so that too being done by the government, and as you said, that since the start of this pandemic, we've had a lot of, immunity boosters being pushed by various companies as well and by various individuals and, supposed treatments as well. And so, as you're saying, we're going to be living with this pandemic, with this disease for a very, very long time. So it's very important to get the right information out there in terms of, how to protect yourself. And also, it's you, the doctors, who are bearing the burden, really, of the public at large, of any carelessness that might take place.
See, today, as I'm talking to you, I have lost more than 440 doctors of mine. If it was so well managed through these protocols, while paying homage to my departed colleagues and nurses, healthcare professionals, and sanitation workers, was it worthwhile? That you don't even have data and you are not even accepted till date. Where are we heading?
All right, Dr. Rajan Sharma, thank you once again for speaking to us here at NDTV, and a very, very important point made. And it's good that this letter is out there so that, the public at large should also pay attention to what doctors in this country are saying. Thanks so much for speaking to us.
Thank you so much.